get the feeling? Did you get it down in your soul?
Hey everybody, this is Dr. Edward Park, and I'm from Recharge Biomedical, and today we're doing our weekly Wednesday webinar, or WWW, on spinal health. Today's topic is spinal health, and we're joined by patient Rocky and his doctor, Dr. Grace Sin, a chiropractor here in Southern California. If we talk about back pain, 80% of people have self-described back pain. At any given time, about 20% of the people are suffering what they would describe as back pain. According to people who keep these figures, the annual expenditure is about $15 billion a year in health insurance and things like that, medicines, but I'm sure it's much higher. And the productivity loss, of course, is hard to quantify. If you go through the so-called, literature, the only things of proven benefit appear to be exercise, and in particular yoga, which is very good for strength and flexibility, but maybe perhaps as a telomerase activator as well. Degeneration of the spine, as with every body part, is normal and natural part of aging. But supposedly the Delphic panels or the people in charge of making expert opinions from all these questionable studies, they say that for discectomy, which is shown above, where you come in and you tear out the disc that's bulging and impinging on nerves, the quote is, any positive or negative effects on the lifetime natural history of underlying disc disease are still unclear. Often done in conjunction is called spinal fusion, shown on the lower right. What that basically entails is placing something metallic to make sure that the adjacent spinal bones don't move, they're fused together. And then in between, that little like crushed beer can thingy is the implant, which will become scarred down. It's made of bone. So what is the spine? Well, we don't talk about a front ache, and we don't talk about my top pain, but everyone talks about back pain. And that's what we call it, and it's one of those things everyone thinks they know what it means. But let's break it down here. So the spinal column is synonymous with vertebral column, which is the same thing as backbone, which is the same thing as spine. Now, the stuff that's inside, we call the spinal cord, but don't worry about that. That's nerves. What we're talking about is just the bones. And if you look on the right, we see it's a double curve. So we have what's called a lordosis, which means a curvature to the ventral side or the belly button, a kyphosis, which is a curvature to your back side, another lordosis in the lumbar area, curvature to the belly button. And then finally, the sacrum and coccyx form a kyphosis to the back. What's inside the spinal cord? Well, it carries sensation. So this is something that every medical student knows, and it's nicely illustrated here. The cervical spine up in the neck, it controls the sensation for the arms, indicated by C1 through 8. The torso is controlled by the thoracal or the thorax dermatomes. These are called dermatomes. So if you have nerve impingement there, as we talked about with Jackie, she had a band of numbness here, and that was because the spinal metastasis of her small cell, as described in podcast 4, was growing into the spinal nerve, which went away after her metastasis went away. Down in the lumbar region, indicated by blue, and this is why people get sciatica shooting back. L4, L5 is this pain radiating down the back, and that's because the disc often protrudes in the L4 to L5 region, causing nerve impingement. The sacral roots are the ones near the bottom, and they control back and inner parts here, as well as the genitals and the area around the anus. What's also inside the spinal cord is movement. So there's sensation and movement. And here we see that this lovely brain and its electrical wiring. From C1 through 8, it controls the neck, the diaphragm, the wrist, the triceps, the fingers. This is why people who, even after spinal injury, can still control their diaphragm and breathe. In the thorax, these are the hands, the abdominals, and oddly enough, ejaculation, which probably is maybe related to the general development, and testicle dermatome, or the testicle origin, and ovaries. In the green, again, we have the hips, the feet, and then in the sacral region, the penis, the vulva, bowel, and bladder are controlled by the sacral motor roots. Finally, what's also inside is the autonomic nervous system, which is just the HVAC, the heating and the air conditioning. So we have the concept from Taoism of yin and yang, meaning the hot and the cold, the yang and the yin. And what's that meant to indicate? Well, everything like the eye, for example, is controlled by opposing forces. So the sympathetic system on the left here comes out of the thoracolumbar, and it controls the eye. So if you're freaked out and you're scared, then your pupil will go pinpoint. Whereas if you're relaxed, then your pupil will dilate. And these are in constant opposition with salivary glands, tear glands. They're all in opposites. The heart, speed up the heart, slow down the heart. And digestion is somewhat separately controlled enterically, but there is an effect there. If you go to some place that relaxes you, a bookstore or a hardware supply store, office supply, maybe your digestion would be improved. Whereas if you're that's because of the cranial, sacral, which is the parasympathetic nervous system. So you might feel like you have to go to the bathroom, but a sympathetic would be, you fall asleep and you almost hit the barrier on the freeway, then you get this sudden jolt, your heart races. Of course, that's not the time to be digesting food. So another reason why your mom told you not to go swimming after you've eaten, because you won't digest. Here's a direct innervation of the adrenal gland, which squeezes out that adrenaline when you almost hit the freeway divider. And of course, the bladder, male and female genitals are also controlled by opposing forces. So what is the back? What's it comprised of? Well, there's bones. And bones here is a picture of a young lady who gets older. As you can see, the kyphosis, which is the backward curvature of the thorax, enhances here. So she bends over, and they also collapse top to bottom, cranial caudally, so you get a shortening of the stature. And it's because the trabecula, the bony substance, is getting weaker and weaker, as shown here, and they just crush like beer cans, and they crush forward generally. If you take a cross-section through an older woman's hip, then you would see that the bone is no longer solid. It's becoming weakened like a honeycomb. Now, on a microstructural level, the bone kind of has this interesting organic shape. There's a kind of a canal in the middle, and it organizes itself in concentric circles, which are connected almost like nerves. It's immediate like connections with these little canaliculi, or tiny channels, I guess you would call. So what happens is the osteoblast migrates into its little pointed spot. It becomes an osteocyte, and it stays there for life. Although it definitely is being remodeled, it's terminally differentiated, meaning it's no longer, immortal. And so bone is constantly, these cells are always dying and being replaced, which is meant to be indicated by these palm trees. Palm trees are interesting. They're actually plants. They're actually not trees. That's why they don't have branches. But in any event, the fibers are constantly being remodeled in response to stress. That's why people and trees are not like structures. Structures generally don't have little nano machines going around and cells that are alive to actively lay down more strength where it's needed. Also in bones, besides the bone, are the cartilage or joints. There are three types of joints. One is in between each vertebral body. There's this gel-like ring. It's like a donut, and you do not want the jelly to spill out of the donut. That's when you get a herniated disc. The second type of joint is called a facet joint, which joins the top and the bottom one, each in line with each other. And this is more like just a rotational joint. It allows you to curve your back forward, curve your back backwards. And so you'll see in this diagram, when you lean backwards, the front will tend to bulge out, and the facet joint will take the burden of that stress, but you can only go so far. If you bend forward, you're relieving the stress here, but the joint is also keeping it together, and you're bulging backwards. On the left here, we see normal disc, degenerated disc. Bulging really bad is herniation. A thinning disc, degeneration, and then when it degenerates, you can also get these things, these bone spurs are called osteophytes, which is something we'll refer back to later. What's not shown here are the third joint, which are the ribs. The ribs come out like wings attached to the side, and that allows you to twist your torso. So those can be a source of back pain. And also, the reason why these things don't bulge all the time is that there are band-like ligaments running up and down, constraining the substance and keeping the whole thing together. What is cartilage on a structural level? Cartilage is these osteocytes. It's just exactly like bones. So the osteoblasts come into their lacunae and become osteocytes and live there forever and build the bony substance. Well, same with fibrocartilage that would be found in your disc. The chondroblasts come in and become chondrocytes in their little lacunae, and they live there for life, and they pump out collagen. When you get a dysfunctional or damaged disc on a microscopic level, it looks disorganized. It's all falling apart. It becomes scarred and not structurally intact as the idealized version is here. The problem with healing cartilage is that they don't have a blood supply per se, and that the cartilage often comes back not as living, growing, healthy fibers, but as some kind of weaker, scarred version. This is really the only slide you need to understand aging, cancer, arthritis. Everything that happens as we get older is due to this, and it's called replicated senescence. And it just means that mechanically copying DNA, you lose 50 to 100 base pairs, the A, C, T, G. It can't be helped because of the mechanics. It can only be assembled in one way, DNA that is, and you can't get the primer to the end. But this is a good thing because we don't want stem cells, non-stem cells, to live forever. Otherwise, you'd look like this, and you'd run out of the ability to sustain yourself in a couple hours. So the queen bees, which are the stem cells, are always in the position to heal themselves with telomerase, but the little drone bees are supposed to die off, as depicted here. If you take a cell that's a regular cell, it starts out just like the queen bee in terms of its integrity of information and its life. So maybe it inherits 10,000 base pairs. If you keep on dividing it, when you hit 50 or 60 times, that colony is dead because the growth of the chromosome abnormalities increases. And that's because of non-disjunction. When the chromosomes get too short, they get stuck to places they don't belong, and you can't get proper separation of the chromosome. Last week, we touched upon, in bone health, the idea of a mesenchymal stem cell, which I referred to as a traveling queen bee for hire. So in your osteocyte or your chondrocyte, you have this little stem cell, which is pumping out all the little drone copies. But if you have this nuked by like chemo or infection, what's going to happen? People don't really know the answer to this. You don't know if the little drone is going to be de-differentiated. As with the hive analogy, they feed a little larvae royal jelly, it becomes a queen, or whether the queen comes from outside. I favor the latter explanation because it makes more sense. When you look here at the mesenchymal stem cell, it can become nerves, fat, cartilage and bone, heart muscle, skeletal muscle, liver cells, and pancreas cells. So what's happening, as these cells burn out, they're probably not being created from differentiated cells that de-differentiate. They're probably coming in from the outside, being differentiated to suit what's needed there. I began to realize they're manifesting my life. Yeah, I know so many ways. Every day I want... very interesting that the body appears to store these mesenchymal stem cells. They're like kind of bugs in amber. So the cartilage just sits there with these little chondrocytes, and it's thought perhaps that they de-differentiate, meaning you have these frozen little cartilage cells, and they de-differentiate backwards, which is unusual, into mesenchymal stem cells, and then they can populate the other organs. So that's kind of a nifty, clever way to keep a frozen copy of a better DNA. And the reason they think that is because when you compare the DNA of the local drones to the new stem cell, it appears to come from a de-differentiated cell, and it's younger than its outside, drone. So, in other words, you get mesenchymal stem cells from the bone marrow, where people think they come from. They're older, quote unquote, shorter telomeres, more damage than the ones that have probably been defrosted from the chondrocyte frozen state, the amber state. All right. So enough boring science. You may have retained some of that. Some of it may be sounding weird, but the point is it's all starting to rhyme. Every week it's going to be the same thing. I'm going to show you papers. It's all because of telomere erosion. And if you're interested in that, there's other videos describing that at YouTube under Dr. Park 65. All right, now the fun stuff. So Rocky is a fellow who's a kind of a brilliant chemical engineer, and he has known about telomerase, as many patients have, for many years, and was excited to try it. He, I assume, was born, we'll hear from him, with scoliosis, which is, instead of an anterior-posterior curvature, it's a curvature seen from behind, sideways, which is very common, a little more common in men, and which can have functional significance and be symptomatic, but oftentimes it's not at all symptomatic. The lordosis of the neck and the head axis is 20 degrees here. It becomes 22.7 after 6 months, and after 9 months, it becomes 30 degrees. So his neck is curving forward a bit more, which is good. His sideways curvature is 11.8 in the thorax. It goes to 9.3 at 6 months, and at 9 months, 9 months, it goes to 8. So again, there's a steady change in a positive direction to straightening. This little curvature in the lumbar area, L1 to L2, went from 4 degrees to 2 degrees to corrected, so it's straight now. And the other left side curvature of his L, I think it's 3 to 5, is 6 degrees at 5 weeks, gone at 6 months, and of course still gone at 9 months. The other significant finding is the degeneration of the discs. Discs were measured on Dr. Sin's x-ray, and at 6 months they had increased anywhere from 0.3 to 1 millimeter, which, you know, may not seem significant to you, but it would be explaining the improvements in the curvature of the spine. We like to think, well, maybe this is just a placebo effect, but the thing that compels us to believe otherwise is that they're all in the same positive direction. It's not a random good and bad. And even more striking is that at 9 months, the effect remains positive on all the discs measured, and even more pronounced. So the improvement was unidirectional, so not random, not some good, not some bad. And they're all even better after 9 months than they were at 6 months. We'll hear now from Dr. Grace Sin, who is a chiropractor in the Redondo Beach area for 18 years. She is a expert and has done extensive training in sports rehab, orthopedics, and pediatrics. And for the prestigious California Chiropractic Association, she teaches other chiropractors her unique technique, her comprehensive chiropractic technique, which doesn't just rely on chiropractic dogma, but integrates many different kinds of things from all fields. Well, first of all, welcome, thanks for being on. I know you're very busy. I guess the question would be, Rocky came to you in July, and that was like 5 weeks after starting TA. And at that time, what did you know about his history, and what can you say about what changes he's had over the course of 9 months?
Sure. When Rocky came to me, he was having on and off lower back pain for about 6 months. He had some sciatica involved, and I did a thorough evaluation of his nervous system, his muscle system, and his skeletal system. So most people don't know what normal structure looks like on a film study, so I'd like to define it for people. In an ideal situation, normal curvature of the spine is approximately 45 degrees. Now, I say approximately because what would hinder that number is this line here, which is your center of gravity line. It's measured at a point on the side lateral skull called the sella turcica, and it's drawn straight down. If you had the perfect head weight distribution, this line would be butted right up against the C4, C5, or cervical 4-5 disc space, T12, which is the 12th thoracic bone, the anterior quarter of the sacral base, and then straight down. That would mean your head weight, which is about 8 to 10 pounds, depending on your genetics, is distributed properly all through the spine. Now, the areas of like darker circles indicate areas of decreased disc space or disc hydration levels, degenerative disc disease going on. When, and I'm going to quote a study by Dr. Rene Callier. He used to be the head of physical medicine at USC in the 90s. He did his own independent neurological study where he found for every inch your center of gravity is anterior or in front of the C4, C5 disc space, you lose about 30% of vital lung capacity. Now, why that is bad is oxygen is necessary for every single cellular reaction in the body. So if you have decrease of vital lung capacity, then things can degenerate at a faster pace. Now, with Rocky, here in the lower cervical spine, he had severe degenerative disc and joint disease, and the mid-thoracic spine, mid-lower thoracic spine, and then definitely the lumbar spine. The anterior-posterior view here, he had the center of gravity off by 21.7 millimeters. Ideally, your center of skull and nasium, which is that nose cartilage bone in the middle here, should be straight down in one line. His was deviated to the left side by 21.7 degrees, and it continued the way his spine bends, 11.8 degrees to the left, which had a compensatory lumbar curve here, 4.4 degrees, and then 6.0 degrees at the lower lumbars here. Now, you see here how his iliac crest or top of the hips are unleveled. The left is 19.2 millimeters lower than the right, and then if you go down the hip joint where the ball and socket joint meet, the acetabulum here, is lowered by 17.4 millimeters. So there's a lot of unleveling going on. After a series of treatment, we retook his film studies, and we have some improvement. So he went from 20.6 degrees to 22.7, and his disc space now at the fifth and sixth disc space of the neck, and then sixth and seventh increased. This area increased by 1.2 millimeters, and then the one right underneath at 1.4 millimeters. His thoracic spine improved in the T5, T6 region by 0.3, 0.4 underneath that, and 0.3 underneath that. Now, they seem like... Excuse me?
Amazing.
Yeah, it was pretty darn amazing. And I do have really good changes for people, but I think by using the TA65, he's getting even better results. That's what I'm seeing. So continuing on from the baseline study to the second study to the third study, which is 9 months after starting care, he went from 20.6 degrees to 30 degrees, and he went from 1 inch forward head posture to 3/8 of forward head posture, significantly better. Cumulatively, from the original measurements to here, he's improved 1.5 millimeters of C5-C6 and 1.8 millimeters. Now, if you stack up all the cumulative increases of disc spaces, that can literally make a grown man taller,
yeah.
if you will.
Yeah, I got a half inch taller after starting, too, which is weird. People just laugh. But
right.
Hey, Rocky, are you on? Can you hear us?
Yes, I am.
Oh, fabulous, fabulous. So thanks for being on. You know, everybody, you need to thank Rocky because this was his idea to do the webinar. Even before I had webinars, he came up and said, you know, Dr. Park, look at these amazing results. We got to tell people about this. So, and that's about half the webinars we do are people just cannot wait to share their good results. So, Rocky, tell me, what about your subjective pain or performance? Have you noticed any change in your...
Well, you know, right now, as I was telling Dr. Grace, I'm pain-free probably for the last 4 months, maybe 5 months. I didn't put a exact day on it, but it's quite a long time at this point, you know. And I'm taller, but I don't have any sciatica right now. I do not have any lower back pain, and the first 6 months of last year was pretty bad because it just reoccurring every
right.
day. Just
now,
didn't seem to get away from it. And
are we talking about decades? Is this something you've had for decades, or was it pretty recent?
I've had it on for decades. I mean,
really?
But,
okay.
So this is, you know, I've gone to other chiropractors, but I just prefer Dr. Grace. I mean, the way she operates, the way they do everything, it's a little bit different because the first thing I noticed when I got there, it looks like an exercise gym. You have very specific exercises for different parts of the spine, and then, and it's all, you know, it's an all-integrated approach. So that got my attention. And then the results kind of speak for themselves. And if you don't have any pain, you know, it's a very big deal, you know. And when you have the bone on the nerve, I like to think of it like this. If I have a copper wire that conducts electricity and I keep smashing it till it's thinner and thinner and thinner, eventually it's going to be at some point where it's not functional and you can't pass the electrical current. I'm not saying that a nerve is exactly like that, but there's some point that when you put pressure on it, it's not going to function and conduct electrical impulses between organs and the brain the way it was designed to do when you were a child or a baby, for example, when everything was just perfect. The point is that if we can increase the discs, then that means that we have less pressure, most likely off nerves, and it's not going to degrade as fast as another guy who's 60 years old.
That's right. Now, you know, interesting, you came to us, and I know you came back at 7 months, and you met Brenda, who's new in the office, and my wife. And you're 60, but they were just flabbergasted because at the time you came in, you looked 59, but, you know, you looked like you were doing everything you can in terms of nutrition, dietary supplement. But at 7 months, you just looked like a guy in his 40s. It was just really, you looked totally like a different person. So I'm thinking perhaps maybe the improvements in the collagen and the skin maybe translated to improved disc space. Do you feel like... I know you've given us a great number of patients who've just seen you after just not seeing you for a long time. They say you look different, you look younger. What about Bonnie, since you got your wife onto it as well? What are the changes that she's had?
Well, the first thing, the visual thing, is that her face, as well as mine, has completely tightened up. She's sitting here next to me, so she can...
Hello.
Hi, Bonnie.
And she had a double chin, and it's gone. It's gone up. It's
wow.
physically gone up, and it's barely noticeable right now. But we've both also had weight loss. But I exercise in the gym, too, so my weight loss, I could tell by my belt. I'm, I was on belt hole number one. Now I'm on belt hole number four today.
I know, I had
but
to get
my weight
all...
is pretty much about the same.
I'm wearing a belt with freshly made holes as well, so that's pretty common. Now, Bonnie, what about your feet and your ears?
Yeah, my ears. I've always had one ear I can't hear as well out of from something that happened to me when I was like 5 or 6.
Mm.
And And recently, I heard crackling in my ear, and I'm like, oh, that's kind of weird, and maybe there's some water in there or something. But after all that crackling was over, I could hear much better out of my right ear than I have for a while. Like, if I'm talking to Rocky in bed, and one of my ears is closed, the good ear is closed, I cannot hear him. Now I can. So I think that's pretty interesting.
Well, I think the coolest thing is the feet. Tell us about that.
So, I've always had, like, athlete's foot on this one toe, and it won't go away, and now it's gone. So I don't know what caused
it. Amazing.
I guess the TA survived.
It's all gone.
Yeah.
So 20 years
of athlete's foot. That's amazing.
Yeah, fungicide on the planet over the years, and nothing has really, you know, seemed to help, but that's gone too.
Yeah, so.
But I had a friend saw me yesterday, and she says, wow, do you look young? Probably hadn't seen me in about a year.
I know.
And was really surprised that I look so much younger. And I have kind of two lines underneath in my chin that seem to be disappearing.
Yeah.
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 And my marionette lines are getting finer and finer and finer.
Well, just the overall appearance changed so much from the beginning to 7 months. You just looked like you were two decades younger. And
yeah.
I know that Nino and also Manish, when they saw you, it was like there was nothing to sell. They say, well, what are you taking? Although that's usually a rhetorical question, and they laugh when you tell them. But people who have the ability to actually research it themselves, you know, it's pretty convincing. Although I have to say seeing is not believing, because if people see me and they see I've lost 30 pounds, they say, well, you must be doing something other than that.
Yeah.
So I think the only way to really believe is to take it. To experience it.
Yeah, you got to take it. I mean, otherwise you'll never know.
Great. Anything else you want to share with people if they're thinking about it and they have back pain? So you went from decades of back pain to no back pain and actual measured functional improvement. So that's pretty good. I mean, I think obviously
that's
the chiro
really
was very helpful.
I think,
also,
you know, Dr. Grace would say that compared to other 60-year-olds that I'm well ahead of the pack. You know what I mean?
I would
improvement.
Agree.
So, you know, but it's, you know, it's a combination. You got to do it together, and I think that's where you'll get the vast improvement.
So, Bonnie, do you get the same improvements that other people are getting in terms of your energy or your sleep?
Yes, definitely better energy and sleeping well. Definitely, yes.
Perfect. Because you guys have a 4-year-old to chase around, right?
Yes, we do. Yeah.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Rocky, for even suggesting this webinar. I hope it benefits other people. I know that was your intent.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah. I'm going to get one more.
Oh, somebody want to know my daily dose. I take two capsules before bed.
Okay, perfect.
From Alan.
Yeah. Thank you.
And I take supplements, too. I take a full range of vitamins and minerals. If I was going to take just one pill or two, it would be TA65.
Yeah, definitely.
It's like the master, you know, if you could, you know, put the telomeres back on, you know, you just repair, you now allow repair to happen.
You get stronger when you get the feel. When you get down in your soul.
Okay, so I have Ray Carrasco, who is my golf instructor over at Shady Canyon, and he is a professional golfer for 40 years, played even as a kid for Garden Grove High, and has won the British Senior Masters, and is, I think, 65. But Ray and I were at the senior golf tournament in Newport Beach this weekend talking to some folks, so we're excited about maybe improving their backs. Hey, Ray, are you on the call?
Hey, great. I'm glad we got through, yeah.
Playing 50 years,
he's
a total genius. He's helped fix my swing, and he has been taking TA65 since what, December?
December 15th.
Perfect. And what have you noticed? What was your back like, and what's it like now?
Well, in the past I've had problems, my L3, 4, and 5s, and I've had, since then it's been fantastic. I used to have to take a couple of Advil in the morning and a couple at night, a lot of painkillers and things, and boy, it's been fantastic. You know, I don't have to take any more anti-inflammatory things. I've noticed I have increased flexibility, and because of that, you know, my attitude is a heck of a lot better. I feel like I've got more energy. You know, my wife's taking it also, and we've noticed immediately such deeper sleep, such really restful sleep. It was fantastic, and some of the side lights, not just feeling good, but I've lost some weight, and my wife's done really well. She's had a good workout regimen, but this has really helped her shed those pounds. So we're very excited about it, and I know it's going to be a continual positive part of our lives.
Yeah. So now Sue has lost 12 pounds, is that right?
Or yeah, yes.
That's great. So it's hard when you go to the gym. Your body doesn't want to lose calories. It's not evolved for that, but somehow she's able to increase her metabolism. And that's fantastic. What about your mom? Is she doing well?
Well, she's doing fine. She's doing fine. She's 84, and, you know, she's had some issues this year, you know, with a bout with pneumonia and some diabetes, but now her numbers are down to normal or coming back, so things are going really nice. So it's been. I'm so happy. I had a chance to get on the range there a few months ago and talk about how have you been doing, and you've lost so much weight, and
yeah.
So to get involved with the TH65 has been great, and I know in the golf niche, the golf world, it's going to make a tremendous difference in people's enjoyment of the game, because they're going to have a more sound sense of well-being.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, it was a lot of fun this weekend. I know you and I went out to the Toshiba tournament there at Newport Beach. We were able to share it with some of the players on the Champions Tour. And I'm just, you know, I know if when they start using it and they have an improved feeling, their performance will improve. I think it's going to be very exciting, and they're going to give you some really good feedback, as I have.
Yeah, I'm excited too. You know, it's not just the weight, but it's everything. Everything gets better. And that's people who use their back to swing a golf club at 110 miles an hour. You know, you're going to get some misuse.
Sure. Wear and tear on it, that's for sure.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Yeah. Anything else you wanted to elaborate on? Tell people who may be considering it, who have back pain. Where was your back pain? L3 to
L5? L3, have, 4, and 5, yeah.
Did you have sciatica? Did you have, like, numbness?
I've had some of that, too. You know, when you have that, and it's so debilitating to your ability to perform, to make a good full swing, and you know, when you have those aches and pains, it's not fun. So it's just wonderful. I mean, it's been great. I mean, I'm looking forward to playing the best golf of my life, and even though I've already played for quite a while, I'm looking forward to
super
rounds.
Yeah, well, you got to win a couple of tournaments for us, my friend, then people.
I'd love to. Yeah, I'd love to. Well, Dr. Park, thank you very much.
All right, sir. Thanks, Ray. We'll see you.
Okay. Right. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Hello, Dr. Park. Hi. I'm here to Alam.
Alam, yes. Okay, everybody. Alam is a nice young lady, 43 now.
About
is that right?
45.
Okay, and so I know Alem from way back. You can tell them how if you want, but how are you feeling? What have you noticed with your back? You've been on since December or January?
I think it's January, about a month and a half or two. And
first of all,
I wanted to say thank you very much, Dr. Park, for everything. And when I started it, I was not sure about this thing, but, you know, this came from Dr. Park because I respect Dr. Park very well. And I said, you know, I'm going to take it. And I have a very severe back pain. And last year in January, I was in emergency hospital for sciatic nerve. I could not move my leg, my hand, and anything. So I stay in emergency room, and they have to give me steroid shot and all kind of stuff. You know, I got better. But my back pain has been with me for a long time, more than a decade. So, and about a month and a half, I'll say 2 months, I started taking the T65. I didn't know what happened. You know, one day I don't have any back pain. For a long time, I'll say over 10 years, I've been suffering with back pain. Now I have none. I don't even complain a thing. That makes Solomon very, very happy, which is my husband. And so, and then,
well,
you know.
Funny. Can I tell them how we know each other?
Sure, you can.
I delivered Alem's twins, Nathan and Eleni, and I was in Starbucks last week, and you were telling me all the great things that you had and feeling, and I said, well, my mom's happy, everybody's happy. And so funny, Nathan looked up at me, and his eyes grew big, and he smiled and nodded, so that was cute.
Absolutely, because Dr. Park, you know, I want everybody to know this, and my back pain is involved everybody, and I ask everyone to come and massage my back. And mm-hmm. sometimes my kids, they worry so much, and they'll come and just do massage my back, and my husband. So right now, everybody's like, you know, Mommy, you are fine. We're happy. You know, they're smiling. Oh. So and this is not the only thing, and I shared this with you, Dr. Park. You know, this is not about, you know, this is a back pain, you know, situation. But I shared with you about the gray hair. It is absolutely, you know, amazing what's going on with me. So this is going to be another, you know, session. But, you know, whoever is taking, you know, the tea, TI-65, and I think personally, and I will say, you know, go ahead and take a chance and take it.
Yeah.
Because if I am away from this back pain, I was in prison in my own body.
Mm.
I was in prison in my own body because I sometimes thought, you know, this is going to kill me. But right now, I don't worry that, you know.
That's
I don't
amazing.
Worry about that. It's really, it's a true statement.
Yeah.
True
now
statement.
And you also, your digestion, your sleep, and your energy and peace of mind, those are all improving.
It
right?
is amazing, Dr. Park. You know me, I have my twins. I work hard. I run around. And my husband asked me a day before yesterday, he said, I don't know how you do it. You know, you do all this stuff. And, you know, how do you do it? And I say, go and talk to Dr. Park. That's all I told him.
It's kind of funny because I know you wanted it for Solomon. And then he was kind of like, well, I don't know if this is really going to work. And he said, well, go ahead. And I think still, even in Starbucks, he kind of was, can this be real? You know, and I think that's normal. I think people, Rocky calls me all the time. He's like, can this be real? But I get those calls all the time. It's hilarious. So we don't believe it either.
Yeah, and
but,
he, he asked me to go ahead and he wants to start mine. I say, no, man, you need to go and buy your own thing. So
Well, don't let him steal it from you. Hey, I want to say goodbye to you. Thanks so much, Alem, for sharing with us.
Thank you very much, Dr. Park. I appreciate it.
Thank you. I want to unmute. That was Alem, one of our patients from my OBGYN practice. And this is Dr. Grace. Are you on still? I want to say goodbye. I know you have to leave.
Yeah, I'm just about to take off. I just want to say thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much. I learned so much from you. And I think it's a really, if everybody has the opportunity to go see someone, like Dr. Gray said, chiropractic is often misunderstood by people. They think it's just all about subluxation, but Dr. Grace is obviously using all the state-of-the-art measurements and different real exercises and retraining, and I think the body does have an intelligence and structure is meant to repair itself if you let it. Is there anything else that you wanted to share with us? I know they can get your phone number from the website. What is that again?
The phone number to the office is 310-540-5529.
Great.
And my website is redondobeachchiropractor.com.
Wonderful.
Okay.
Awesome. Great.
So,
thanks so much.
My pleasure, and thank you. Have a great day.
You too.
Bye-bye.
All right. Well, so is there anybody else who has a question? I know I've been kind of remiss in following the chat dialogue. It's kind of hard. Brenda, anyone else? Anything else? Linda has a question. Oh, perfect. Linda, are you on? Can we hear you?
Yes, I am on. Can you
perfect.
Hear me?
Yes, I can. Thank you. Go ahead.
Good. Well, I have arthritis of the spine and degenerated disc and some herniated disc, and I had a severe whiplash years ago, and I've got some scoliosis. I fit everything that you've mentioned here with some osteophytes, so I'm definitely interested. I'm doing chiropractic. That's what keeps me going at all at this point. I'm 61. And so I'm definitely interested in the TA-65. I was wondering about the supplements for getting some of that disc regeneration, what your suggestions for that might be.
Well, I'm kind of a one-trick pony. You know, I'm not that up on supplements. I'm not a big believer. I think chondroitin sulfate has some benefit, but in general, clean living is clean living. If you sleep a lot and if you eat well and exercise, that's the best you can do. But the nice thing about TA65 is giving you that rejuvenation from the inside, from the cells, in a natural way, in a very limited way. And it's doing all those things that are good for your health, but while you sleep. I don't think there is any other supplement that will do the same thing. Hey, Rocky, do you want to say something? Hey, Rock, are you on?
Yes, I'm here.
Oh, perfect. Did you want to answer Linda about other supplements? Because you know about 100 times more than I do about supplements, so.
Yeah, it's the TA65 that's regenerating the discs. I mean, I've taken the same supplements, you know, for probably years and years and years, but nothing makes the difference like the TA65, you know, where you see this, you know, dramatic improvement, you know.
I was wondering if you took extra collagen or any enzymes or anything like that as your regular supplements. No, that wasn't necessary, huh?
No, I don't take any enzymes. I don't take any collagen, no.
It didn't seem to make a difference with me, but I didn't know that maybe I would still need that with the TA65, but you don't think so?
I really don't think so. I think once the telomeres increase in length, that regeneration starts not only there, but it's everywhere. You know, it's not just that, but, you know, we're focusing on that today, but, I mean, it's everywhere. I mean, it enhances your immune system. I mean, it tightens your skin. I mean, it's
that sounds, why pay for a facelift? Do this, you know? You know, you get the whole body regeneration.
That's the way you have to think of it, because that's what's really happened. I mean, I was telling Dr. Park, we have a 4-year-old, and she brings home colds like nothing. And I had a cold twice this year. Each one lasted a day. Full symptoms, but gone in a day. And that's because your T cells are so amped up, and, you know, they're just doing their thing. They just wipe it out. So.
Yeah, I know. I've had a couple of colds, and they just started in my throat, and they ended in my throat a day later. They never went anywhere else. It's weird. I've never had anything like that.
Is this something that you stay on continually, do you think?
Me?
The change is permanent, you know, but I would. I can't see stopping.
Yeah, okay. I was also wondering, did you see any resolution in your osteophytes? There's no reason that eventually that wouldn't happen also.
Well, bone is a living organ. It's always remodeling, and osteophytes are just damage. Yeah.
Definitely not out of the realm of possibility.
Who knows?
Yeah. Well, thank you.
All right, thanks for the call.
Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah, and if you're interested, just give us a call at the office, and we'll get you a bottle out. You can try it.
I will be calling, definitely.
Perfect. All right, thanks. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Alan has a question. All right, as Dr. Grace was mentioning, the reason the lung capacity changes is because the curvature comes forward and it crushes the thorax. But also, if you take this diagram of bone matrix and pretend that it's lung tissue, same deal. So COPD is just death of these cells from poor stem cells, just the aging of the stem cells. So the lungs give away, you don't have as much lung. You get COPD, the bones give away, you don't have much bone, osteoporosis. The collagen gives away, you get degenerative joints. So it's all the same disease. It's not that difficult to understand. And the reason why it all is the same disease is because of this. They're all replaced by these mesenchymal stem cells, fat, cartilage, bone, muscles of the heart and body, pancreas and liver. I mean, someone mentioned the pancreas. The gal in our office gives her mom insulin, used to be 40 a day, now it's 10. And the only reason I can think is because the damaged pancreatic islet cells are getting killed, and then another mesenchymal stem cell is defrosted, comes in and does a better job. So you have these replacement parts, they want to be distributed, but because there's a dysfunctional stem cell currently occupying that niche, that's, you're still old. But all right.
This is Rocky. I have one comment. My mother was diabetic, and I check my blood sugar routinely. And what I've found is now I would routinely get rising, fasting blood sugar in the morning in the high 90s. Mm. Now it's in the high 80s.
Mm,
it's about a 10-point drop on average with TA65.
That's huge.
That's huge. That's huge. So I'm getting younger.
There is no question, sir. I mean, they say seeing is believing, but when you walked in at 7 months, I too was flabbergasted. And I think it speaks to the point that if you're young enough, you're going to get dramatic results. If you're already 80, a lot of stem cells cannot be replaced or refurbished, so you're not, your appearance is not going to be dramatically altered. You know, if you're in on the cusp, 40 to 60, and you're taking good shape or haven't gotten a lot of stem cell death or errors, you can get dramatic facial appearance. Your friend Manish, who saw you and on the spot wanted to sign up, I talked to him yesterday. He said he's got a facelift now. His double chin is going away, and his gut is going away. I think he's lost 5 or 6 pounds in like 3 weeks.
Wow.
So he's happy as can be also. Is there anything else you wanted to leave us with, Rock?
No, I covered it.
Cool. All right, cool stuff. Unless there's any other questions, we're going to go ahead and end it. All right, everybody, thanks a lot. Bye-bye. Did you get here?